The Jaguars have a hole to fill. Rodney Gunter is retiring because of a heart condition. He released a statement last night saying, quote, "There is a 50-50 chance that surgery would fix my current health condition, but at the moment, I don't meet the criteria to undergo an operation. This time, I can't play or have the surgery, so I must wait. So at this moment, the best choice for me and my family is to walk away from this game." Joining me now to talk about the condition, Dr. Pamela Rama, a cardiologist from Baptist Health. Good morning. Thanks for being here.
Good morning.
So let's talk about his enlarged aorta. What exactly is the condition? How does it occur?
So the aorta is the biggest vessel or artery in the body, and it's connected to the base of the heart. And basically, all of the blood travels through the aorta to get to the other organs, to supply the other organs. So what happens is that the wall of the aorta has three layers of tissue. And because of genetic problems or hypertension, the middle portion of this wall is weakened. And so think of it like, you know, a normal aorta should be like a PVC pipe, and it's, you know, sturdy. But when you have this type of condition, it's like a balloon, so it's able to bulge out and enlarge. And that's the condition that we call an aortic aneurysm.
So usually there are no symptoms. How do they find it?
You know, unfortunately, there's no symptoms until it becomes catastrophic, right? So if you have a rupture or a dissection, which you feel pain and symptoms, it almost is too late because that's a catastrophic complication of the aortic aneurysm. So we find it by routine, you know, sometimes it's associated with a heart murmur. So they do an echocardiogram or some cardiac imaging to find the aortic aneurysm.
Now, you mentioned genetic conditions, mostly hereditary?
Yes, so a lot of them are hereditary. That is correct.
Yeah, and isn't it, I did some reading, more common in people over 65 or people who have tissue disorders?
Yes, you know, so it's more common in older patients. However, you could see it in younger people as well, particularly when they're part of a genetic syndrome like Marfan syndrome or Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. So there are certain syndromes that appear younger in patients.
And I know that smoking can be a risk factor, but that's probably not the case with Gunter.
That is correct, yes. Smoking is a risk factor, so is uncontrolled hypertension.
So Gunter was talking about the fact that, you know, surgery can sometimes be used to correct it, but he may not be a candidate at this time. What would make him a candidate?
So we generally look at the size of the aneurysm, and so for certain conditions, we accept a lower size. Like, for example, you had a bicuspid aortic valve, we would do our operations at 5.0 centimeters. However, generally speaking, 5.5 centimeters is the cutoff for considering surgery for this type of patient. And the other thing, too, is how fast it grows. So if it grows over 1 centimeter over a year, then that would be an indication that it's an unstable issue and that, you know, surgery is indicated at that time.
So could he have surgery? And this is all hypothetical because we don't know all the particulars about his case and you've not studied his case. Could he possibly have surgery in the future?
He could possibly have surgery in the future, but generally speaking, when you've had an aortic aneurysm, we really do not recommend competitive sports, especially the ones that causes body collision, because the aorta is weakened, and so, you know, there's a chance of rupture and dissection, which can be catastrophic.
So he said he has to step away from the game at this point in time. Are we talking about career ending here?
You know, I think so.
Very sad. Dr. Pamela Rama, thank you very much for some insight there. Appreciate your time as always.